My name is Julie Williams. I'm a professional preservationist at the INL. I'm also the group lead in the INL Cultural Resource Management Program. One of my responsibilities is to protect the remnants of World War II and post-war activities on the INL, such as this 200-ton gantry crane. During World War II, the Navy used what's now the central portion of the INL to test fire conventional ordnance. The ordnance was manufactured, relined, or repaired at the Naval Ordnance Plant in Pocatello and shipped north by rail approximately 60 miles to what was called the Arco Naval Proving Ground. It was then offloaded using this large gantry crane and test fired to the northwest. The ordnance tested ranged in size from 3 inches to 16 inches in diameter and included the large caliber guns and ammunition used by the Pacific Fleet. During and after the war, the U.S. Army used two secluded areas located near the Arco Naval Proving Ground as aerial bombing ranges. Bomb groups and fighter squadrons trained at the Pocatello Army Air Base and flew north to the aerial ranges to practice high-altitude bombing techniques. The Proving Ground ceased operations in 1948, and Army and Navy personnel cleared some of the test ordnance before vacating the Proving Ground. In 1949, the Atomic Energy Commission, predecessor to the Department of Energy, established the nation's nuclear reactor test site at the former Proving Ground. Since that time, 52 one-of-a-kind and first-of-a-kind reactors and their support facilities have been constructed there. In 1997, historians determined that 300 buildings associated with the World War II and nation's pioneering nuclear era were eligible for listing on the National Register of Historic Places. Although many have been torn down, their important contributions to nuclear energy and reactor safety have been preserved through steps outlined in the INL Cultural Resource Management Plan.